Every CockroachDB binary comes with a built-in dashboard called the Admin UI, which provides details about your cluster configuration, your data, and your workload. It helps you optimize cluster performance by monitoring different areas. You've already seen the Admin UI, but here we'll explore more of its functionality. The Admin UI is a tool used for examining relatively stable clusters. It's important to note that if several nodes fail, sometimes components of the Admin UI, things like the login or time series metrics, will also fail. I've already started a 3-node insecure cluster. We'll access its Admin UI and get acquainted with the information that it presents. Let's find the URL. And here's the cluster overview page. It provides details about the cluster nodes, whether they're alive or dead, replication status, uptime, and key hardware metrics. On the left, you can see that there are 5 tabs: overview, metrics, databases, statements, and jobs. The metrics overview dashboard lets you monitor important SQL performance, replication, and storage metrics. It displays time series graphs for SQL queries, service latency, replicas per node, and storage capacity. You can use the dropdowns at the top to show different cluster metrics. You can see metrics for your cluster or for just one of the nodes. You can also find lots of different and useful metrics dashboards. An important one is a hardware dashboard, which lets you monitor CPU usage, disk throughput, network traffic, storage capacity, and memory. It's important to note that these graphs show the hardware consumption by the CockroachDB process only. And you can also toggle between different time periods for which to view metrics. The databases page of the Admin UI provides details of the databases configured, the tables in each database, and the grants assigned to each user. If you click on a table in the database, the table schema displays. Schema information, like whether there are indexes configured or if the table is partitioned, are shown here through the table's DML. The statements page helps you identify frequently executed or high latency SQL statements. It also allows you to view the details of an individual SQL statement by clicking on the statement to view the statement details page. On the statement details page, you can view the logical plan for the statement as well as the breakdown of the phases for executing the statement. These can expose opportunities for query performance tuning. And lastly, the jobs page provides details about the backup restore jobs, schema changes, user-created table statistics and automatic table statistics jobs, and change feeds performed across all the nodes in the cluster. Now you know how to access the Admin UI and have gotten a preview about what it can tell you. Go ahead and check it out for yourself. Feel free to browse around and be sure to check out all of our docs for descriptions of the graphs and metrics in the Admin UI.